When working with C#, the integrated development environment to use is Visual Studio. That is Microsoft's premier IDE. This doesn't mean that this is your only option. There are lots of other third-party IDEs out there which you can use to write your code. That said, Visual Studio is a great first starting point, and well, it's free. Well, this wasn't always the case. In the old days, Visual Studio cost a pretty penny. These days, we have the Community Edition, which gives us access to a lot of the other Microsoft core languages. Mind you, there are qualifications for the Community Edition. Essentially, you need to be an indie developer, be part of an education setting, or doing open source work. Otherwise, you'll need to pay for the professional license. Now, the Community Edition comes with a bare bones amount of features, and as you grow as a developer, you can expand your feature set by upgrading to the professional or enterprise versions. Visual Studio is also available for macOS as well. This is a somewhat recent development. This course was designed for Visual Studio on Windows, so if you are taking this on macOS, things are going to look differently and they may behave differently as well. I haven't tested this on macOS. If you get stuck, leave a comment for the episode and we'll do our best to walk you through it. To get started writing in C#, we need to install Visual Studio. Now to do this, we can simply open up our browser. So here I have my browser and I have my search engine selected. If you have a search engine, just navigate to it now and you want to look up Visual Studio. Now you'll see for Google, this is the first result returned, Visual Studio IDE, and it's visualstudio.microsoft.com. So make sure to click this link. Now on this page, you can see we have these various different versions of Visual Studio. The one we're interested in is the Visual Studio IDE. So when you hover over download for Windows, you have a few options. Let's select Community 2017. With that, we go to a download page and you can just save it onto your desktop. I'm going to close this now and I'm going to launch Visual Studio here. I'm going to click run and it's going to do some updating of the installer here. You see we have the Visual Studio installer. Just click continue. And it may take a little bit for it to download some new files, but once it's all done, then you get to choose what you can install. So here we have our configuration and we have a bunch of things we can choose from. Now what we're interested in is .NET desktop development. Now you can see here, you can also install C++, you have ASP.NET and all the various different languages that sort of hook into the .NET framework as well. If you're interested in installing any of these, you can always run the installer again. But for now, let's just select .NET desktop development and then click the install button here. Now the installer is going to be downloading some files over the network, so it may take a little bit of time for this to run through its paces. Okay, now that we have Visual Studio installed, we can actually start using it. And you can see here, it have picked up my user account. So if you're not logged in, you're gonna wanna do that now. So let's click on Start Visual Studio. And here we are with the start page. And the start page will run every single time you start Visual Studio. Now the account system is built directly into Visual Studio. So you can click over here where it says my name. You can click here and then add your account if it's not already there. Now, if you choose not to use an account, the Community Edition will run for 30 days and then it will stop. So it does require you to be logged in order to use it. Now, what we want to do is create a new solution. A new solution, you can think of it as a container for projects. You can have multiple different projects inside of a solution. So you may be thinking about an app, let's just say a tip calculator. Your solution may contain a project that contains all the code to run your tip calculator, another project for the user interface of the tip calculator, another project for tests for your tip calculator, and even another project, say, if you wanted to provide a console app for your tip calculator. So the solution contains projects. So we're going to come up here, we're going to choose File, we're going to do New. And since this is going to be a new solution, we'll just choose new project like so, and that's going to create a new solution for us. Now for the project name, what we're going to call this is Beginning C#. Now you can see we have the locations. We can choose the solution name, which is matching our project name, and we have our framework. What we're not going to do is we're not going to add to source control, but if you have Git installed on your computer, you can automatically hook into that. Now for the type of project here, I want to choose a console app like so. and then just click OK. And with that, we have our new project all ready to go, up and running. As you work with Visual Studio, you'll get an understanding of all the various windows and how things work. I'm not going to walk you through each option at a time, but I will give you a general layout. So you can see here we have our menu bars, and here are some various icons that you'll be learning throughout the course. On your left, you'll see we have these tabs here. If you just click these will open up like so, and you can just close them as well by clicking that X over here. And you'll see we have our Solution Explorer, and this is our current project beginning C#. As you add more projects, they'll be listed under here. And what's nice is you can have projects reference other projects. For now, we're going to be doing everything in the beginning C# project like so. And you can see we have properties as well down here. Now, we'll be doing everything in this file here called program.cs, and we can find it over here in our beginning C#, and you can see the program here. So we're going to be doing everything within this file, at least in the beginning here. And when you look at this, you can see we have all this code. This doesn't make sense at all right now, so don't worry about it. By the time you get to the end of this course, you'll understand completely what this program is doing. And I'll give you a hint, it's not doing anything at the moment.
How was installing Visual Studio? Were you able to get it up and running without any issues? If you got stuck, let us know in the comments, and we may be able to walk you through it. Otherwise, keep an eye on this channel as more videos will be coming out on C#. We'll see you then. Cheers.